Good morning and God bless you. We're delighted to have you with us here this morning. Maybe this is your first time tuning in and joining us. We extend a warm welcome to you and trust that you're blessed with what you hear today. We want to begin with prayer, and I want to dedicate this prayer this morning to the families that have been devastated and impacted by this tragedy that took place in Texas. Our hearts, our thoughts, our prayers, and I know that that's almost become like a political soundbite for people to say you're in our thoughts and prayers. But when you're apostolic, there's a deeper process that's involved in that. We say that sincerely when we say that our thoughts and our prayers are with those families, siblings, just this entire nation is reeling after this tragedy yesterday. So we want to pray, and I'm inviting you to pray with me. We're going to pray specifically for the family members and that entire community and our entire nation. Let's pray together. Father, by the authority of the name of Jesus, we love you, we praise you, we worship you. You are an ever-present help in time of need. Father, we pray specifically for these families that have been forever impacted by the tragedy that took place yesterday. We pray for the everlasting arms to wrap around in a special measure. God, we pray for your presence, your spirit, your glory to be with these family members in a way that only you can be. And we pray, oh God, for the God of all comfort to be with these family members, siblings, parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, nephews, however far and wide it needs to go. God, we just pray for your spirit to bring comfort and strength to these immediate family members, community, and our nation. And God, we will continue to pray that and believe that. And we are asking that in the name above every name, the name of Jesus Christ. And everybody said, amen. I want to draw your attention to a passage of scripture that's found in the New Testament, in the epistles, that is unlike any other passage of scripture that can be found in the epistles. 2 Corinthians chapter number 1 and verse number 3 is where we're going to begin. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings which we also suffer. Or whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. The God of all comfort. This is an amazing passage of scripture. It's the only scripture that I can think of that actually uses this phraseology, the God of all comfort. I cannot think of any other place. There might be another place, but off the top of my theological head, I cannot think of another passage that describes God as the God of all comfort. And the Apostle Paul, being the incredible spiritual leader that he was, he moves into this incredible parenthetical passage of scripture by describing how comfort is disseminated to others, and the others in this particular passage of scripture is talking about the church of the living God. And the Apostle Paul, being the spiritual father, we know that he was the spiritual father to Timothy, but he was the spiritual father to these congregations where they began through his efforts as the apostle in his missionary journeys. In another place, he said, "Ye have not many fathers," and he was including himself in that as the description as being the spiritual father, not the biological father, not the heavenly father, but the spiritual father to multitudes, entire congregations that were began through his efforts. But he is describing an incredible process here that I don't really believe is described like this in any other passage in the Word of God. I want to read through this again. "Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy and the God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble." Now, he is already posturing his role as a leader of saying that what we are going through, what we are experiencing, what we are enduring is for your benefit. That is the highest form, at least in this relationship, of apostolic leadership, of recognizing that I am being a first partaker of the first fruits. I am experiencing tribulation for your benefit. He already defines that the God is the God of all comfort, and then he postures himself as being one that is experiencing tribulation. And everybody else, or those that he is addressing, are the beneficiaries of the Apostle Paul experiencing these tribulations. This is exactly what this scripture is describing. "Who comforteth us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort them which are in any trouble by the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God." Which means I am being postured by God to experience certain things so that as I approach God and receive from God, I can freely allow that to go through me, through that tribulation or through that experience that I am enduring, for the benefit of others, for the sole benefit of others. This is allowing us to understand that there is a reciprocity to everything that I am enduring. I am enduring certain things so that I myself can relate to the needs of others, or relate to the afflictions of others, or relate to the struggles of others. And so that how in my situation that I'm enduring as a leader, I can go to God, and as I receive those divine resources, I can allow those resources to flow through me that have been deposited in me, but now it's time for those to flow out of me, or to go out of me through ministry, through compassion, through comfort of others. And thereby, what God has given to me is now being directly given to others through ministry. Powerful, powerful understanding. For as the sufferings of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also aboundeth by Christ. The Apostle Paul is giving incredible legitimacy to the afflictions and the sufferings that befall all of us, that it is not just for the singular individual experience. There is nothing that I'm experiencing that is just to be just for me. It has purpose. It has purpose for others, for the sake of others, for the strengthening of others. I love this when Jesus looked at the Apostle Peter after the Apostle Peter's denial of Jesus, after his failure, if you please, his sifting of Satan, but he's now coming back to Jesus, and now Jesus is giving purpose to the Apostle Peter as a result of what he's just experienced. He said, strengthen thy brethren. And then he further defines that by saying, feed my sheep, feed my lambs. That what you have just experienced, Peter, although it involves your denying me, I'm going to use that for my purposes. And it's going to be so that you can strengthen the brethren. You can now encourage others that have failed. You can now be a strength and a comfort to others that are being told to walk away from me. That you yourself in your situation can be used to be a strength to my church. Amazing. Amazing. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring. Everybody said enduring. It almost seems to me that God is purging his church. And the one determining factor is who is going to endure unto the end. This word here is in the context of enduring suffering, which is effectual in the enduring of the same sufferings which we also suffer, and whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. So as a leader, whether I am going through the suffering part, or whether I'm in the being comforted and I'm in that part of the cycle, I have gone through the affliction, I've gone through the suffering, and now I'm experiencing the comfort part. Whether it's the suffering or the comforting, it's for others. Everything that I am experiencing, it is so it can be given away in ministry. Whether to wrap an arm around somebody, whether it's a word of encouragement, whether it's a prayer for them, whether it's just to talk to somebody and maybe just be a good listener and encourage them. Everything that I am experiencing, it is for others. The God of all comfort. There's somebody that needs comfort. There will always be somebody that needs to be comforted, and God is the source. Thank you for joining us here today. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow.